Groot Rugby gaan saam met 'n lekker braai. Dis die eg Suid-Afrikaanse kombinasie, soos jy en Pick n Pay.
Right, Chef Chart, so the smells coming from this barbecue out here this morning, you know, I know you prepared already, but I need you to show me how to make these damn peri-peri chicken skewers, man.
No, definitely. Well, we're going to just make something really simple. It's all about convenience. It's easy. Pick n Pay, a great selection just to make your life easy there. So we're going to make peri-peri skewers using some lovely knorr.
Nice.
We've got some lovely coriander, fresh mint and chicken. And the recipe also calls on for a little bit of yogurt there. So those are our real core ingredients to start with, which we're going to get stuck into. And then I've got a few little extras just to zhuzh it up a little bit.
Zhuzh it up. Love it. So you would say this is a perfect recipe, you know, to celebrate that win today.
Oh yes, jeepers, we're all looking forward to that win there. So certainly something to pop down, go and get these ingredients and literally pop it onto your braai later on. So I'm just going to dice up the chicken breast that we've got here.
Okay.
So we're just going to, nice big chunky pieces. There's nothing
lovely.
Sort of, especially in South Africa, there's nothing that's delicate at all. It's really chunky sort of bits and pieces. So let's get all that into there. And then literally we're just going to put this marinade together and nice and simple, and then just put it straight onto the braai. Nice hot braai that we've got already.
Oh,
really
man.
Important, it's hot.
It needs to be hot.
Absolutely, there's nothing worse than sort of, you know, something that's taking forever to heat up there, which I think we all get sort of wrong on the braai at some stage.
Exactly. You know? Okay, but I'm sure you also don't want to burn the meat, right?
No, not at all. You don't want to burn that meat at all, so you want to give that, it's got to have that the balance there. I'm just going to sort of just rinse my hands here.
You're going to stick me to work, eh?
You're going to put you to work. I will put you to work just now. So let's just get this on. I'll get this onto the braai there, get that out the way, and then we'll start really making our salsa. I'll get you to blend all those lovely fresh ingredients together as well there.
Sounds good.
So
sounds
lovely and simple. I'm just going to get some coriander, some mint there. Just easiest, best way to chop up your herbs there. Literally, just put into a bunch there, and with your knife, rock and chop. Okay, so rock and chop. Yeah, so rocking motion is really important, keeping the knife on the board the whole time there.
That's it, and keep obviously your fingers out the way.
Hopefully, yes. Tuck your digits underneath there.
You don't
need sort of chunky nails in there. I know the Asians are about taste and texture, but you got to stay well away from that there. So literally, just to love it, some lovely fresh herbs.
Oh, you can smell that
there.
Mint coming out there.
Oh, gorgeous, isn't
beautiful.
It?
Beautiful.
And then literally, we're just going to pop in some of this peri-peri sauce there. That's the knorr peri-peri sauce there. Really nice and simple there. And if I can ask you just to give that a good mix there, blend all the flavors.
I'm good
there.
At mixing, eh?
So imagine you've got this lovely, fresh, juicy chicken breast. You've got that lovely, sweet chili sort of sauce coming through as well. And that freshness coming through from the coriander and the mint there. I
mean, that smells amazing.
Absolutely fantastic there. As simple as that. It's quick, it's
easy. Is that it?
That is it.
Just like that.
Oh,
my word.
Like that. It's just great there.
So I wasn't lying when I said you're going to show us a very quick and simple recipe.
You weren't lying at all. Right, fantastic. Thanks very much.
Can I pop that
into there? Absolutely. Now what I've got is I've got some bamboo skewers just soaked in there. Now the reason I've soaked them in the water is I don't want them really to burn on the briars as well. So
that's
it just stops them igniting there. So what we're going to do is just literally get a couple of pieces and just
lovely.
Thread that.
Can I help you?
On there. Absolutely. Let's get stuck in here. Let's get all this put onto here. And again, just layer it there. Now you could add lots of other ingredients in between if you really wanted to, but again, you know, we are South Africans at the end of the day, and we're just
like
a bunch of carnivores that just want to eat loads of meat. So let's just get stuck into it just fill that skewer, really pack it there quite nice and tightly. So again, you can imagine all these flavors there. So how's that smell there?
Yes, I wish you guys can smell at home. This really smells amazing.
Absolutely gorgeous.
Sure.
So it's as simple as that. We've got two lovely skewers from there. So again, really hearty, meaty sort of skewer there.
And I'm obviously a little bit slower than you.
No, you know, a bit of experience. You know, takes time. Come work in the kitchen for a bit, and off we go.
A little bit, yeah. Sounds good. Sounds
brilliant.
Good.
Brilliant. So I'm not going to go any bigger than that there. I think
that's
absolutely perfect sort of size there. And what we're going to do is let's just pop that straight onto the actual braai here and let that cook in. Now, really important, we're just going to pop it in and just leave alone. That's a real sort of trick there. So anyway, let's just get all that out the way. I'm just going to sort of rinse my fingers off.
That's it.
There.
Sorry.
And
there
right.
We go.
Thank you. All right. So that's on there. Really important. Let's leave it alone. Okay. I really want to create that seal between the chicken and the braai there.
That's it.
Do you know how many times we actually turn our braai steaks or our pieces of chicken on the meat in the braai at home? Any idea?
No idea.
36 times on average.
Really?
Yeah. 36
that
times.
Mean?
We all stand around there and we turn and we turn and we turn and we turn. You know what? Best just leave it alone.
Leave it.
Hopefully it'll sort of separate a little bit and you can watch it actually cooking through.
Yeah.
We'll turn it a couple of times there and that's it. Done. So I'll warm up a few bit later on.
There's some nice braai advice as well for you.
Absolutely. So let's get stuck into actually just making a little bit of a lovely salsa together.
Cool. Before we do that, I mean, just to get to the recipe for the guys at home, if you did miss what we just did, you can just SMS Knorr, K-N-O-R-R to 33728, and that recipe will send right through your cell phone. So you can make this some of this morning still.
Right. Absolutely. Especially after that win there. Right, what I'd like you to do is let's blend this together. If you want to grab a spoon out of there, and I'm just making a salsa. Just some lovely, fresh tomatoes, cucumber, and red onion. I've literally simply just diced them. Okay. That's it.
Did you take out the insides to get rid of the water?
We've taken a bit of the seeds there. We've taken the seeds there, so just the juicy flesh there. A little extravagant, but why not? A nice little short step there. So in with our tomatoes there, and our onion
finely chopped onions
as well, finely diced there, and then let's go with a bit of cucumber there just for a little bit of flavour there.
Nice
colours. Give that a bit of taste there. Absolutely, it was fresh, it's vibrant, it's exciting. Yeah. That's what it all should be about. It's really festive out here, so it's really important. So whilst you're just tossing that, a little seasoning always helps there. Salt drawing loads of flavour, and then a bit of pepper just to sort of complement.
Nice.
That combination there. So
nice.
Simple as that. You could throw loads of herbs in there. I'm not going to do that now. But again, great simple salsa.
That's very simple,
really easily done on that there.
Wow, I'm going to have a super breakfast this morning.
I tell you, what a way to start a breakfast anyway. Brilliant. And then what we've got here, so that's our salsa done. Now what the recipe did call for was the yogurt, as we mentioned earlier on there. So
yes, you did.
Lovely fresh yogurt there that we're going to... we're just going to, again, just fuse up. We're going to spice up a little bit there. So, again, just take some herbs, again, the same herbs that you used for your actual marinade of your chicken there. And, again, let's just scrunch those all up there.
Ooh.
So you can imagine, again, also lovely freshness coming through. There's loads of other herbs that you could sort of add there, some lovely basil or something as well you could really put together.
Yeah.
So let's take that. Let's slide that into a little glass bowl there. And then we've got some yogurt we're going to add, and then just for a little bit of zing,
a little bit
of lemon zest there.
We'll
use this little microplane. Now, you know where I usually find this?
No, where?
In the bathroom. The missus takes it
and
uses it. So, you know, just look for it. I always hide it now and again, but it does disappear from time to time.
Well, this one is a new one, right?
This is brand spanking new. Absolutely, you haven't had time to touch this at all. So, anyway, so a little bit of lemon zest there. So, let's just sort of grate that there. And again, you can imagine that real freshness coming through there.
Oh, I mean, there's nothing like a minty flavour, some lemon zest. How's those sausages doing?
They are doing very, very well there. They're just ticking along there quite happily. Okay. A little happy chicken there.
You see, I would have gone and checked it already and turned it, but you obviously know what you're doing.
I'm quite confident with it, but I think, you know, it's all very important that we just leave it alone. It'll do its own thing.
It'll do its own thing, right? So I like it.
Don't rush it. Leave it alone. Right, so let's get some lovely bit of fresh yogurt in there.
Ooh,
and
you want to
get that a bit of a mix there. Let's combine all that together and see what you think there.
I've actually
some lovely flavours there.
Seen something like this.
A little seasoning as well.
And this is just plain yogurt.
That's just plain yogurt there. You could add creme fraiche, cream cheese. Again, there's a great selection there that you could choose from in store there. So make up your mind of what you really want to do there. I'm just going to add a little bit more in there as
check
well. Just
there.
So nice and simply done there. Bob's your uncle. Great.
Bob Junko, and that's done.
And it's just simple, all about convenience at the end of the day. So let's go move across back to the braai.
Oh, look who made his way into the kitchen, the braai area, man.
I'm not here to say a word, I'm just here to eat.
It's the smells, right? You kind of came floating in.
Yeah. I was supposed to go get ready to perform, but then I thought, no, let me just come past here quickly.
Oh, no, that's good, man. But I'm sure you're a big braai man, aren't you?
Yeah, we have a lot of braais in my place.
Yeah? Best meat,
I don't do a lot of the braai. A friend of mine called Brian.
Brian.
He does really, really good braais.
Yeah. Wow.
Really good braais,
But I mean, are you seeing what Charles is doing here? He's
this
literally
is brilliant,
just
man.
Leaving it there because he says we turn it too often.
Absolutely. No. And that's all true. That's very, very true.
Yeah?
You, sit there,
you believe
watch
that?
Me.
And you just like keep on turning it. It's like part of it, you know, you're holding something like, yo, you know, because, you know, tomorrow. Yeah, another poker gonna play, eh?
Oh, we turn and we turn there. But you know,
exactly.
You keen to get hold of these tongs.
I am,
that's
yeah.
Really far away. Away. Absolutely far away.
Ooh.
So, right, what I've got some made up earlier on here, I'm just gonna pop those on there just to literally just to warm them up
look
very
at
slightly
that.
There. So, again,
nice.
Just to make sure I feed you guys, get a bit hungry, or the lured and all these lovely, lovely smells there.
Let me tell you something. I tasted a little bit of this Knorr sauce earlier on, and it's still like got a little bit of a twinge in my mouth. You know, I can feel that burning. It's a very, very nice spicy sauce. So, I hope you like spicy stuff. You know,
absolutely.
You're gonna sing and all that.
Absolutely. I like spicy stuff.
It's gonna open up the vocals.
Absolutely. Yeah? Oh, it's just lovely. That's bit of
it's like
there.
Opens everything up, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Interesting thing. Chili. What is the hottest part of the chili? Any idea?
The pips.
No, not.
No?
It's not the
pips. It's that white membrane. You know that white part in there that holds all the seeds together?
Yes.
That's
yes.
the hottest part.
Really?
Then it's the seeds, and then it's
the
flesh. The flesh is actually really quite sweet there. So again, probably loads of lovely bits of seeds in there. You can imagine. I'm sure that's lovely little speckles of that gorgeous sauce there.
Yeah.
And then you've got that pith, and then that lovely fresh flesh as well there. So you've got that combination. So again, wow, all that flavor, sweetness and that real sharpness on that there.
Yeah, lovely.
So really simply all coming together here. So literally, we're just going to finish off this now. Let's just take it all together here.
Oh,
we've got our... skewers there. Whoops, that nearly disappeared there. And literally, just to finish off there, imagine you got your lovely, gorgeous little bit of sort of yogurt and then your salsa there.
Just like that. Come on, Orange. We need to taste this.
Get stuck in there.
Tuck in, dude.
Should I go?
Let's go for it.
All right, cool. How do I eat with
your hands? With your hands, dude. That's how South Africans do it. We eat with our hands.
Okay, cool.
Oh, man, that looks amazing.
Maybe even more sensible. Back in there.
Well, I'll have this one.
Ken, lovely freshness. How's that?
Wow. Wow. That's the best chicken kebab I've ever tasted.
Good to hear.
Thank you so much, Chart.
Absolutely.
But listen up, we came across this whole Pick n Pay ad thing, right? And it's this picture, we'll probably show it a little bit later on. And there's a Pick n Pay, it says it's got a bowl like this, but it's empty with a few crumbs, all right? It's gonna be on screen now, so check this out. It says, please sir, may I have some moa? Or, please sir, can I have some moa? How's that? Clever stuff, eh? Clever
Very
stuff,
clever.
I like that. But anyway, Chart, thank you so much, man.
Absolute pleasure.
Noiso, are you gonna finish that?
Later,
I shouldn't eat it.
Later, we're going to keep it there.
Awesome,
back
awesome,
on
guys.
We'll keep it on there.
Lovely stuff, guys. All right, so listen up. The next date that you need to put in your diary would be the 8th of October, because that is when the Kaap Report Quick and Your Tall 3 finalists go head-to-head, and it's going to be a fun-filled day. We're going to be there, and of course, you are invited, so let's go check this out.
Stay with Expresso and SABC3.